between the two. That is where people like me come in, who know from the past, present, and the future.
That's a clip.
Having introduced myself with that clip, I'm concerned. You know, I'm told that there are some people who voted themselves out of parliament in the last session over the constitution. The issue which my brother Peter Sinkaba has raised, all because they were shy to bring out their utmost feelings on a particular issue, like that of the 12. I'm not one of those who are shy to bring out those issues. Of course, about the degrees, but I'm not talking about the 12. I'm talking about an issue which looks unpopular. Eh? You fail to raise it, all because you are afraid. I'm told that they are going to be. Of course, it has been clarified to say it is not good. It's not yet the policy.
Please get to the point.
Yes, I'm getting to the point. The point is, we are not talking about government printers printing our ballot papers. What has happened at all? There has been pressure and so on, to a point where now people are even ashamed of talking about the government printing papers. And yet, freedom fighters, like the one I was talking about, we're telling us at the time of independence, we're going to show that the African is capable of running his own affairs. That's not running our own affairs, if at all. We run to other places to print our ballot papers, because it's a very fundamental issue. I know that I may be told this late, but we want to register it, to say that the government printers must be considered. Many people, I don't know what the governments are afraid of, they forget that His Excellency Dr. Kaunda lost the power with ballot papers from government printer, not from outside.
Mr. Mansa, you are summing up.
Yes, I'm summing up. Thank you. The other one is on nomination. I don't know what time it will come about. Do we still have time for that? Just one?
Yes, sentence. Nomination phase will be discussed as we go on.
Okay, yes. Then I wind up there.
Thank you very much. Please switch off the mic, President Mongoti. I'm praying it's very brief.
Thank you, Chair. Your Honor, the Vice President, all protocols observed. I'm worried about one issue. We seem to be treating the voting of security people very casually. It's a constitutional right that they also enjoy. And I'm disappointed that the Electoral Commission, over the years, they've been aware that the officers of the state who are sent into duty, and so far, it would appear it's a new problem. It can't be a new problem. We've had this problem for many, many years. So please don't push it on us to break the law by stopping them from voting. The last decision where they were not vote, they did not vote, is unfortunate. We should not repeat that. And I think all presidents here would want to see them vote. And that's my wish as a person as well. Secondly, we have a referendum vote coming. The time for voting, would that be adequate? Considering that the referendum vote requires so many people to vote, unless the law is amended, 50% of eligible.
Yes.
How long will that take to vote? Have we taken that into consideration, that you will have a challenge on your hands in terms of time? Thirdly, I like to believe that the Electoral Commission is not the referendum commission. They're wearing two hats and they sit there. Time for Parliament is running out. By Tuesday next week, I'm sure, Your Honor, you're supposed to be adjourning. When are we going to have these bills passed? Our enemy now is time. So if we can continue saying, we'll look at it in future, we're cheating ourselves, because time of Parliament is running out. And the Constitution says 90 days before the election, you can't move that. The challenge for you as a Commission Chair, we are pushing you not because we don't like you, but you have a duty on your hands for the country. Thank you.
Thank you very much, President Ikai.